Web AudioConf. Welcome to the sneak peek of prototyping MIDI controllers with web technologies. My name is Max, and in the next couple minutes, I'll build a touch-enabled MIDI controller in only 15 lines of JavaScript. I'm super excited to speak at Web AudioConf 2021. My full talk will be more in-depth and cover topics like gamepad input, peer-to-peer connection, and computer vision. First, what are MIDI controllers? The MIDI standard allows audio devices and software to send messages to each other. For example, in the DJing space, hardware DJ controllers with buttons, keys, faders, jog wheels, and rotary knobs are connected to a laptop and send messages to a DJ software to control music playback and effects. Building hardware controllers or standalone applications can require extensive knowledge and resources. Prototypes and experiments can also suffer from long iteration times. Using the Web MIDI JavaScript API, the browser can now connect to these MIDI devices. Programming with Web MIDI requires no compilation and gives you access to the huge amount of JavaScript libraries and web technologies. This makes Web MIDI the perfect platform for prototypes and experiments. So, let's get started. To gain access to all MIDI devices that are connected to your computer, call Request MIDI Access. We use the returned MIDI Access instance to iterate over all output ports and open each one of them. Then we define a helper function sendMIDIMessage that broadcasts a given message to all output ports. Now we define another helper function that sends a MIDI node on command identified by hex 90, a pitch and velocity. In the MIDI standard, node on messages refer to hitting notes on a piano. A pitch of 0 maps to the lowest C note and velocity maps to how hard this key has been hit. Audio software and other MIDI devices understand the same messages but map them to different things, for example, moving a crossfader or changing effects. Pitch and velocity no longer necessarily have a musical meaning. My DJ software treats the pitch more as data channel ID and velocity as the data value. Let's use these functions to build the prototype. People access the web with a variety of input devices, including touchscreen, trackpad, mouse, stylus, and more. Browser vendors put a lot of work in to make websites accessible for all these different input modes. This has been abstracted for us into the Web Pointer Events API. We'll piggyback on this work and build a widely usable MIDI controller. It will control three parameters at once by tracking the user's pointer location and pressure. To use this API, we register a pointer move event listener that is called whenever the pointer's position changes. This happens when the user moves their finger on the trackpad or touchscreen or moves the mouse. The pointer's absolute X and Y position, normalized touch pressure, and any button presses are passed into our callback. First, we alias our helper functions. If the screen or mouse button has been pressed, we call node on. If the user does not press the mouse button or only hovers the trackpad, we call node off. Next, we normalize the X and Y position in relation to the window size. These two values will be sent as MIDI messages with pitch 0 and 1. Finally, the touch pressure will be sent as message with pitch 2. Ultimately, this code sends three MIDI messages whenever the user moves their finger. Now, let's run this prototype. All these slides have been built with web technologies and run right in the browser. On this slide, you see two Web MIDI devices. The browser frame runs the code from the previous slides. I did add some polishing, for example, rendering the coordinates. In the bottom of this slide, you see a MIDI input that displays message velocity in the three indicators. To connect the two, I configured a MIDI loopback software on my computer that passes messages from the touch controller to the indicators. Now, moving the pointer horizontally controls the value of the pitch 0, which is displayed in the left. Vertical movements are shown in the center indicator. The touch pressure is shown on the right. My mouse reports all clicks as having 50% pressure. Controlling three signals with one hand or finger is very powerful. For example, we could map these to a delay effect where horizontal movements control the wetness, vertical the rate, and pressure the feedback. And that's how you prototype a MIDI controller in only 15 lines of code. You can find the whole code licensed under MIT at the linked GitHub repo. I'm excited to share more in-depth prototypes with you at Web AudioConf and talk about future possibilities and technical limitations. My full talk will include controlling audio with an Xbox controller, connecting remote MIDI devices with a WebRTC peer-to-peer connection, and controlling effects through hand gestures in front of the webcam. See you at Web AudioConf.